And I'm happy that you picked an earlier Dylan song, because I didn't plan this, but this next song is from 63.
Okay.
And it's a very, yeah, it's a
Yeah,
scaled
yeah,
back Dylan. Much of the same, you get the more folky kind. This is not necessarily a political song. It's a song about a relationship that he's had. And I quite like it because it's a beautiful song, I think. Like the way he sings it is a very nice song.
it's beautiful.
But the lyrics are scathing. And Ziggy, you were talking to me. You had an interesting interpretation that I want to hear more about after we play the song.
Okay. This is Don't Think Twice, It's All
Don't
Right.
Think by from the Freewheelin' Bob Dylan,
63.
63.
Well, it ain't no use to sit and wonder why, baby. Even you don't know by now. And it ain't no use to sit and wonder why, baby. It'll never do somehow. When your rooster crows at the break of dawn, look out your window and I'll be gone. You're the reason I'm traveling on, but don't think twice, it's all right. And it ain't no use in the turning on your light, babe, the light I never knowed. And it ain't no use in turning on your light, babe, I'm on the dark side of the road. But I wish there was something you would do or say to try and make me change my mind and stay. But we never did too much talking anyway. But don't think twice, it's all right. And calling out my name, gal, like you never done before. And it ain't no use in calling out my name, gal, I can't hear you anymore. I'm a thinking and a wondering, walking down the road. I once loved a woman, a child, I'm told. I give her my heart, but she wanted my soul. Don't think twice, it's all right. So long, honey, baby, where I'm bound, I can't tell. Goodbye is too good a word, baby. So I just say fairly well. I ain't saying you treated me unkind. You could have done better, but I don't mind. You just kind of wasted my precious time. But don't think twice, it's all right.
One thing I've noticed about this song is there's a lot of like he makes a statement and then there's a very short like kind of either addition or contradictory, like it's, you
yeah.
know, It ain't no use to sit and wonder why, babe. It don't matter anyhow.
Like a comment.
Yeah. Like, it's like a little comment. It ain't no use to turn on your light, babe. The light I never knowed. It ain't no use in calling out my name, girl, like you never did before. It's just, you know, but goodbye's too good a word, gal. So I'll just say fare thee well. Like, it's just, it's a lot of the structure is just making a statement.
Yeah.
And then a comment after the statement.
Yeah, yeah.
And even like musically, you know, it's kind of this song kind of light thing, and then it drops and it's just like speaking comment. Yeah, yeah. Which is a very interesting structure, and to me makes for a very pleasant song beyond the meaning of it.
Mm. Yeah, absolutely. It's like he's talking, at least like the first half of each like verse, because he goes like, you'll make a statement, and then, well, it don't matter anyhow. and then the second half of like the verse, he'll just, you know.
Oh, you're right.
Speak a bit. So it's not like every time there's a comment, but it's like that structure. You have like the first half of the verses, it has that kind of like statement comment structure, and then it's more kind of like rambling.
You're 100% right.
At the end of it,
in the four stanzas.
When I say verse, I think I mean
oh, stanza. Okay, yeah, in the four verses.
Or stanza, I'm not sure what's the correct
term. Neither am I. But anyway, verses or stanzas, the first like four lines of each verse have that simple statement, comment, statement, comment.
Yeah.
And then after that, then the last four lines are fuller. I mean, I think we could theoretically count and say exactly what the rhythm is, but I don't really feel like doing that.
Yeah, I mean, and also like the he goes to a particular chord, like a dominant chord. I'm not sure, you know, what one it is, but like the kind of chord structure of the song also mirrors that lyric structure.
Mm-hmm.
And melody structure as well.
And if we take the song, like at its face value, like meaning, he's writing this about someone that he knew.
Yeah.
You know, it's a song that to me is like, if you were to like epitomize it, it's like, I really cared about you, and I'm hurt. But don't worry about it.
Yeah.
You know?
But it's okay.
It's okay. Because it wasn't that much.
Yeah.
I
mean, it sounds like quite a lot, but I feel like maybe rather than saying, but it wasn't that much, it's more, yeah, it was pretty intense, but it's okay. I'm fine with it now.
Mm-hmm.
So it's more like this kind of peace almost. But for that reason, to me, it almost makes it even sadder. You know, it's like, yeah, he's found peace with this thing, but it also reckons with the very intense sadness and almost like grief at the loss of this relationship. Maybe he isn't feeling the grief, but
mm-hmm.
but you can almost sense how his partner would be feeling just with this very short song. It's quite incredible.
But even like in this fourth verse, when he says, but goodbye is too good a word, gal, so I'll just say fare thee well. I think that's what he does here is really funny, because so instead of saying, right, like obviously goodbye and fare thee well are kind of synonyms,
mm-hmm.
but good bye, he changes that to like, you know, fairly, kind of fairly and good. So fairly is like a lesser word of good.
Maybe. Or it could also be just like a poetic, you know, like a structural, I mean, like it rolls really well, kind of like musically, the line. Or like goodbye is too good a word, you know?
Yeah.
You also have the goodbye and the good there in mm-hmm. the same
And then, the same, you know, sentence. You could have done better, but I don't mind.
Yeah.
Right? It's like, all right, you know, but then it's like, So this, you could have done better. I don't mind. It's like, okay, like I'm fine with it. But then the next one, it's like, you just kind of wasted my precious time. Yeah. So it's like, you just kind of, which is seems casual, and then it's wasted my precious time, you know?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's like very harsh about the feeling that he feels from this breakup. But he does it in such a way where it's like, it's so casual the way that he says how hurt he is.
I mean, it also sounds like he's talking, you know? Like it might seem harsh to tell someone you wasted my precious time. But if you say, hey, like you kind of wasted my precious time, it's like he's still trying to be gentle. He's still trying to be like careful in how he expresses his honesty and sadness. In how honestly he expresses his sadness. Mm-hmm.
And you were saying before we hit record that you think that, or you had heard that this song, that Dylan actually has flipped the roles. So in reality, he's talking, he is the girl.
So a friend of mine told me that, this might be available on Wikipedia. I'm not sure where he read it. I can't quite remember, but he said that that Dylan did flip the roles in this story. So I don't know why. Maybe musically or as like a poem, it made more sense to write it this way. But you know, like to write it in the first person.
Mm-hmm.
But I think it might be about a real relationship that Dylan had, but he was the one who behaved the way the partner of the person expressing themselves in this song behaved. So he is actually the girl, and she is the one who would be saying these things. Don't think twice, it's all right. So he would have wasted her precious time. He's the one who wanted her soul despite her having given him her heart.
Mm.
Which is interesting. I don't think it changes the beauty of the song, but maybe it would signal a sort of reckoning, or maybe trying to twist the facts about his relationship. You know, like trying to pin it all on her rather than owning up to the fact that it was him. But I don't know enough about that to make that judgment.
Yeah, I just think it's a. You know, there's not a lot like politically that we can get into here, but I just think it's a really beautiful song. And it's, to me, it's a classic kind of style of Dylan's music where he's saying something really serious and profound.
Mm.
But he puts this like casual, well, it's all right. You know, don't think twice. That makes the song complete, because if he just gave you like this very passionate, this very, I'm so hurt, I'm it's meant so much to me, like that, it would be what everybody else is doing.
Yeah.
Right? And he kind of does that, but at the same time, it's what makes it so unique is this element of I'm fine. Don't worry about me.
No, for sure.
But I love.
It's fantastic. It's really, really beautiful. I'm really happy you picked this one. I think I like it was on my short list for sure.
Nice.
I also kind of feel like we've gone from some very lyrically heavy. Not that this one isn't lyrically heavy. It's extremely lyrically heavy. But I mean, when I say heavy, I mean maybe the emphasis in the song is perhaps more on the lyrics and less on the music, to some songs where maybe the balance is a bit higher. As in, like, don't think twice, it's all right. And the next one, Senor, are, I think, songs that where the lyrics and the music perhaps complement each other a bit more, or there's more of a balance between music and lyrics than there is in the previous songs we've looked at.
Mm.